yes, I made a very successful movie, but the experience of it wasn't personally a success. Whereas this one, you know, it's been 2 years. It's been really difficult to get into the world, but the passion has kind of kept it alive for both of us, I think.
I did want to ask you about that experience because I've heard different things, but I always like to get it from the person themselves.
Yeah.
That there was issues with you and the author. That was where the creative differences lied. What was that experience on set like for you, and why were you not involved in the following two movies?
It was difficult because, you know, and I can say it with sort of compassion now that I have distance from it, but, you know, E.L. James wrote the books. They were very much in her mind and in her world, and she had a very specific way that she wanted this movie shot. And I came on board as a, you know, creative artistic director, which is why they hired me, with a polar opposite vision. And so the two of us, you know, we collided. but you know, we got the movie made and it became, you know, successful and everything. And but personally, I found it incredibly difficult to have that. And you know, the studio wasn't the issue; they were supportive. But it was just, you know, like I said, in hindsight, two very strong visions. And in fairness to her, it was her book, and she had a particular way she wanted it to be seen. And I was making a movie and knew that it needed to be different from that. And yeah, the tussle was real.
Whose vision did we end up seeing?
I mean,
no, I think it's a mix. I think the thing is, what happens is, I think, you know, it's just
that was husband material right there.
There's just many, many compromises along the way. You know, it's not really that it tends to be. In some cases, it does. I mean, you hear of it too, and you know, Sam's just not really like a director for hire just to do that job. You know, like you're asking for so much more when you. When you hire Sam as director, she takes on the whole thing, and it's a visual experience, and she's a leader on set, and it's a whole different thing, you know. And I think probably because she was an artist in, you know, before being a filmmaker, having complete control of her work. And you see it nowadays as well. Studios will pluck an incredible director that's got first-time film in Sundance, stick him on the biggest studio movie, and then there's problems halfway through because they have different, you know, they have their voices completely
but
different.
But to go back to the question, I think, you know, I think the movie really was, yes, there were compromises, but, you know, it did work and it became successful. But there are definite things that I really wish were still in the movie. And, you know, and if... and
can you talk about them?
Oh, God, I wish. no.
Or just other ideas that you wanted to strive to do.
There was a lot of ideas to explore, but whatever. It is what it is. And like I said... Success. How do you measure it? But you know, now I couldn't go through the journey of 2 and 3 in the same way, and I don't think they could either. And it was, you know, it wasn't a sort of acrimonious, angry parting of ways. It was just like probably best. Mm-hmm. And you know, and I think if I, you know, saw Erica today, I'd give her a hug and say, you know what, it all worked out just fine.